That's the game between Manchester United and Sevilla. Yes, the Europa semi-final game that was played yesterday. We did see the likes of Manchester United this time around losing three finals. They've been there three finals, losing three final games too. And the big question a lot of people are asking is, where did Ole Gunnar Solskjaer get it wrong, especially staging his players so coming?
It's been that, you know, the quality to cross the last hurdle. You understand? You can imagine a kind of, you know, a player like Jadon Sancho they've been, you know, tracking all season, you know, in that team, and they will have taken, you know, some of their chances off from, you know, you ask yourself the likes of Mason Greenwood and
I'm
Martial, they are not really Manchester United.
And he made the changes so late as well. Is it that he doesn't understand?
It's one of the problems that, you know, a lot of people have been, you know, have been tackling Ole Gunnar Solskjaer with. Yeah, if you really want to decide game, you decide game and give the incoming players time to make impact in the game.
Exactly.
You saw when in the Manchester City match against Lyon, when Mahrez came on, 10 minutes after that, you know, Manchester City equalized. That's what you need to bring into the game. You can't bring in a player in like 10, 15 minutes before the end of the match, and you expect him to, like, okay, turn the match totally around for you when you know the quality of that player is not really that kind of, you know, high class quality that can really change the game.
Is it a case of him not having the quality of players? Because this manager, when he was employed,
he came out
to say that, oh, I can win anything with this set of players.
Remember the same players have been winning, you know, when the second phase of the league started.
Mm.
They've been winning. It's not like...
So what happened?
I think there's a little bit of tactical error somewhere. Like he said, you know, bringing in the right players at the right time. You have to look at your players, know their quality, individual quality, their input in that particular game. You know, where there's a weakness, where there's... You know how to pad this whole thing up. The changes came in very late. And you can't expect the players to do magic.
And looking at Sevilla, I was saying right now,
Sevilla, the Europa League is their best right. You can't take it away from them.
Look at the attack line,
for God's sake.
You just have to, like, give kudos to, you know, Julian Lopetegui.
Yeah.
You know, when he came into Sevilla, he turned the team around because they were on the verge of, you know,
crashing, having a disastrous
season.
Yeah.
And he turned it around for them. See where they are now. They qualify for the Champions League on the table, and now they are in.
You would have even brought our brother in.
Maybe that's just a sign for Manchester United, also for Manchester City. So, two Manchesters are out of the European competition. One, UEFA Champions League. The other one, Europa
League. Mean the Spanish coaches
just
and the English coaches for them.
Anyways, just to let you know that today's second game of the semi-finals will be played today, 8 p.m. is the time. Inter Milan against Shakhtar Donetsk. I want to put both of you on spot. Mm-hmm. Just a quick one. What are we expecting tonight? Joel, let me start with you.
Before the match,
is there an upset?
There's going to be a big upset. I'm expecting an upset. Seriously.
So what that means is Shakhtar Donetsk can spring surprise against Inter Milan.
They really want to. The coach said, "I'm going for the final. I'm going for the cup." That was what he said. So
okay.
I'm expecting an upset tonight.
Do you agree? Do you see that happening?
Inter Milan straight win.
Okay, Inter Milan straight win. So what Sukumi is saying is Inter Milan will play Sevilla in the finals of the Europa League. And just also to let you know that the UEFA Champions League 2 will be played tomorrow. That's the game between Lyon against Bayern and also PSG against RB Leipzig. Yes, just before we call it a wrap on the show today, we've got some transfer news. Players moving from one club to the other, and Sukumi will be just dishing out those vital information.
Yeah, very quick one. Dayo Upamecano, although even, you know, a defender for Leipzig, RB Leipzig, even though he has signed a new contract, Real Madrid are on him now for the £1 million.
And there's a negotiation for
they want to, like, replace aging Sergio Ramos.
Mm.
Then Chelsea are closing on a deal for Brighton defender Lewis Dunk for £40 million. They need defender, but if you ask me, if you want to replace somebody like Rudiger and Christensen and Kozuma, is Luis Dunk from Brighton the kind of player you should be looking at? Yeah, Arsenal, they are very close to, you know.
I wouldn't want to question that because I mean they have it.
Talking about Arsenal, I saw that finally Williams.
Yeah, Phil Williams, you know, he's an Arsenal player.
Well, his contract.
I think there was a little bit of jojo between William and the management of Chelsea.
Yeah,
we'll talk about that later, not now.
So Arsenal, they are on the verge of agreeing a deal with Aubameyang, £250,000 per week.
Wow. He's a world-class player.
Then very quick one, Paulo Dybala. This guy said he's tired of Juventus putting him on transfer list every season. This is what happens. Now he said, you know what? I just want to get a new club outside there. Real Madrid is on him right now.
He was the best player in the league.
Yes, he was the best player because he brought the best out of Cristiano Ronaldo. I just don't know. If they want to sell him, let Juventus come.
Guardiola might come and,
pick him up. And he plays for Manchester City,
say Guardiola should go and buy another team.
For Guardiola, he should continue with this team. He spent enough on right now.
Guardiola should continue.
So what are we talking about?
He's going to win that championship.
He has spent almost...
He will win the championship.
He should replicate his spending.
The owners are not
spent
complaining. Al-Masoud is not complaining. He has the money.
But this is what Wenger is talking about.
But we are not talking about him having the money. We are talking about the credibility.
How would you bring in a 50 million player defender in just one season?
Back to back for three seasons.
It is not a point. It's not a talking point, Mr. Sukomi.
Do we have a transfer? I understand where Joab is going.
Give me a look at transfer.
He's a Manchester City fan.
Give me a look at transfer, please, all right?
I understand. Other transfer, Otto?
Liverpool, they've offered Thiago Alcantara of Bayern Munich, 4-year deal. Mm. 4-year deal. And because if they don't sign him now, in 5 months, the guy will be free. Bayern don't want to lose him. Liverpool want to relax a little bit. Probably they can get him on the free. But Bayern say, buy him now or never buy him.
Oh, sorry. All right, just come and play it on like 4 or 5 million.
So I think that's a wrap.
You don't want
for
that
me.
To happen.
That's a wrap for me.
He's a good
now.
Player anyway.
Well, he is a good player anyway because he's done so well for Bayern Munich.
Honestly,
at least when they have gotten to, he's played a very prominent and pivotal role for Bayern.
Can I just chip in something before we leave?
Okay.
Now we have 3 coaches qualifying for the final. 3 German coaches. Does it mean the German coaches
we're
are better
talk
than
about that.
All the coaches in the world?
And even we're even going to talk about the pairing itself. Mm-hmm. It's a 2-team coming from the German Bundesliga and also 2 teams coming from the French Ligue 1. Then the question now is it that these 2 clubs are better than the other?
For this season they are.
These 4 teams coming from 2 separate
two seasons ago. It was Chelsea. Well, Chelsea, Arsenal,
and there was a time we had
Tottenham, Liverpool. Whole 4 coming from one country.
It's going to be the Nazis against the French.
Okay.
Yes,
coaches.
What I'm saying is, does it mean the German coaches are better than other coaches?
Your club did it in
England.
To an extent.
There is something they are getting right.
Tuchel is a German. Mm.
Joy, there is something they are getting right, and that is grassroots football. You understand?
Tactical play.
Don't forget the fact that German Bundesliga has been so good in the last 4 years, opening their league to young players coming from Europe.
And do you know they have up to Division 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7?
Jadon Sancho is an Manchester City reject. You understand? Mm. Alan Pardew. Mm. This guy that our own assist Ramon that left. Lookman that left Everton. All of them are in Germany now. Jude Bellingham just left with Birmingham City.
I remember we have an Awoni coming from England.
You understand? A lot of them are going to German Mainz. Bundesliga now. And don't forget that German Bundesliga is the only league in the game that has the most spectators in the whole wide world. And their ticket is very, very cheap. Encouraging people to come to the stadium.
Well, it's good to say that.
Yeah,
Gennaro
is a German.
Gennaro is a German. He has to act like his brother.
And I feel that's the reason why Barcelona too are looking for Koeman to let him come in.
Koeman is a Dutch.
I beg your pardon.
He's going to mix the Dutch style of play with the Tiki Taka.
Well, sort of. Yeah. Dutch and German, sort of like that. Anyways, let's see how that one pans out. In that one, I've been told we should wrap up, but just tomorrow is the Champions League.
Sure.
So let's quickly do a semi-finals or finals of the Champions League. Lyon
against
Bayern.
To the final?
Who goes to the final?
No, Bayern. Bayern goes to the final.
PSG, Leipzig.
I'm picking Leipzig.
Okay, so
same
Bayern,
team.
Leipzig.
Same team.
Bayern, Leipzig. So what that means is that definitely going to be an upsetting again. Anyways, that's the size of the show today. Thank you so much, guys, for being part of the show
today. Thank you
very much. Always been here.
Thank you so much.
And for you out there, so we say a very big thank you too for being out and for being part of the show too with us today. From us to you, we say a very big thank you once more. I remain Francisca Nwobodo. Until we come your way again next time, it's bye for now.